Alright, so if you're not a PvP player, I'm not going to waste your time. Basically, your framerate is going to be pretty good no matter what. It doesn't matter if you are playing on a Series X or Series S or PlayStation 5. And it doesn't matter if you are running the game in Performance or Performance RT, you're gonna get pretty much the same result. I mean, even visually speaking, there is barely any difference whatsoever, so... Also, another thing, changing the resolution of your console is not going to help. It's not going to affect performance in any way. If you think that by lowering the resolution of your game you're gonna get a better frame rate, you're wrong. The game is set to internally run at a very specific resolution and you cannot change that. If I had to guess, I would say that on performance and performance RT, on Series X and PS5, the game is running at 1440p. Maybe a bit more, maybe a bit less. And of course, Fidelity Mode seems to be 4K. On Series S, however, I can guarantee you that the game is running at a much lower resolution in comparison to the Series X. There is a lot of blur on Series S. It's almost like the game is running at 900p. It looks pretty blurry. Of course, in Fidelity Mode, it's gonna look much better, but well, you're gonna get 30fps, so it fucking sucks ass. In fact, I don't recommend Fidelity Mode on Series S because the framerate will actually drop below 30. So anyway, that was it. If you're not a PvP player, you can now leave this video. You're welcome, I didn't waste your time. Now, if you are a PvP player, things are different. Let's say that you enjoy doing PvP in free mode. Well, unfortunately for you, the FPS is going to drop, and it can go down pretty low. Now, I think that there are two reasons for that, and it doesn't matter what platform you're on. First reason, the resolution. As I said before, on Series X and the PS5, both games are being rendered at a fairly high resolution, something around 1440p. And this, of course, absolutely does not help when it comes to the frame rate. Second reason, and this is probably the biggest one, the new effects. With expanded on consoles, you are going to get new effects, like the smoke, the fire, the explosions, all that shit. And unfortunately, this is going to destroy your framerate, and there is nothing you can do about it. Now, USA this, the Series X seems to perform the best out of the three. And again, it doesn't matter if you are on Performance or Performance RT, it's pretty much the same shit. The Series S seems to perform the worst, which is of course to be expected from this kind of hardware. And the PS5 is in the middle. So yes, the Series X does perform a bit better than the PS5. It's not a massive difference, but it is noticeable. I did notice it. I played an entire day on Series X and the other day on PlayStation 5, and there is a small difference. And to be honest, this is not very surprising. The Xbox Series X does have slightly better specs than the PlayStation 5, it's a fact. Now, as I said before, the Series S is the worst. The problem is, whenever there is an explosion on screen, the GPU cannot handle that shit and the Series S fucking die, basically. Now, I also made a direct comparison with the PC version, where I shot with the Hydra Cannon in a private lobby, and as expected, the framerate went down like crazy because of those new effects. However, as you guys can see, on PC I did the exact same shit, and the FPS never dropped once below 60. And the reason for that is because the PC version does not use those new fancy effects and the smoke and explosions and all that shit that we have on GTA Expanded on consoles. So a very easy way to fix this on Expanded will be to simply give us the option to not use those effects. Sure, I'm not gonna lie, it does look very cool, but at the end of the day, I don't give one single fuck about fancy explosions. All I care about is the fucking framerate. Like seriously, will it be too hard to simply give us a choice? They did it on PC, like, on PC you can tweak everything, that's fucking amazing. All I want is to turn down the graphics a little bit to have 60fps most of the time in PvP, that's literally all I want. And like, this is the same shit with motion blur, actually. A lot of people are complaining about this shit on Expanded because you cannot disable it. And they're right, this is fucking annoying. I mean, in my case, I've got a fucking monitor that does motion blur reduction, because I fucking hate motion blur. And now Rockstar is forcing me to have motion blur directly in my game and I cannot disable that shit, what the fuck. Like, this is the kind of shit that pisses me off. It was the exact same shit back then with Half VinSync on the old version of GTA 5. I even made a video about this shit. Rockstar did not give us the option to disable that fucking setting, it was annoying as hell. So anyway, please, Rockstar, let us tweak the graphic settings in the game. Or at least let us disable all those new fancy effects. Oh, and another thing before I end this video, please, Rockstar, improve the render distance to see other players from very far away. Because the render distance is still fucking dogshit on Expanded, unfortunately. PC does that way better, still.